everybody, Georgia here, and I'm trying our new style of toy reviews. Mostly like every other person known to a toy kind, such as, Spin's Toy Bin or whatever. And of course today I'm reviewing My Little Pony. Yeah, these are just the generic ones, which I got for my birthday. These three are the generic My Little Ponies. And of course, they look like, yeah, you look like they're from Generation 3. The star of eyes clearly referencing a Generation 3 style. And, the kitty marks. Yeah, the kitty marks are pretty much all the same. They're just random marks that, yeah. And of course, you don't notice that the company just says, for its girl stuff. Bloomer Pony. Yeah, that star. Pretty much the same model, but with a different colour. I guess what this one is. Yeah, it's still got the price. It cost my mum £5.99, which is terrible. It's also from its girl stuff. And of course, it comes with little clips and stuff. And of course, there, yeah, it's still the same style as Generation 3. You see what this one's called? It's called a Pretty Pony. And of course, as Ashens, or whatever his name is, says, he says it's got a sad onion. Yeah, so it says right there, the sad onion. On there, it has Ashen says. And of course, let's open them up,
as
shall we?
As you can see,
these are the box. And sure enough, these two actually are from the same model. Because they've got the same faces, same glitter style. And of course, we've got the Hasbro syndrome thing going on, with only cutie marks on the other one side. And we know the style is pretty good, it's solid, and it's got that sort of furry feel to it. But it's still generic, they feel hollow, they feel solid. Guess what this one feels like. This one smells of cheap plastic that you get in McDonald's toys. Yeah, it smells of cheap plastic, and it's hollow as heck. You squish it, like it's melting. That sort of stuff. Because clearly, you can pull off his head. That's how hollow it is, and put it back on. Because you notice what, they didn't have a kitty mark, so instead they put the company on it. That's his kitty mark. It's a company logo. Anyway, enough all the generic stuff. Oh, by the way, here's all the accessories it comes with. Don't forget, it costs £5.99. For a generic My Little Pony, possibly made for babies. But nothing it goes against. Yep, I got the real thing. Yeah, I wanted to do that. Yep, I got the real thing. I got the real generic. These are real from Hasbro. These are real Hasbro. Can you see? Real Hasbro. That's the real company and made the real ponies, and sure enough it's got all the characters, and I don't know why, but why would Fluttershy and Derpy join the Wonderbolts? I thought Derpy wasn't even allowed due to her lack of eyesight. Because isn't like the Wonderbolts equivalent to like the Royal Air Force or something in Equestria? Because you need a proper eyesight to fly around, and Fluttershy's too scared of everything to fly. Oh yeah. Yeah, she's just scared of everything. But sadly, they added her amongst all the other ponies. They added the cheerleader Pinkie Pie from that Olympics episode. And of course, you can see Sauron in the back there. And of course, they all got the glasses instead of Pinkie Pie. And of course, it's up to 3+. So it's not really a choking hazard. Yep, these are probably better than these generic Generation 3 modelled ponies. I don't know why, there's loads of people out there make their own and they get sued. And of course you see all their names. And of course for Derpy, it's only a muffin. Let me have a picture of a muffin, because apparently the name Derpy is offensive. That's why they changed her look and got rid of her. Yeah, you see, notice her eyes seem to be normal here. But at the back, well, let's check out the design of the let's check out the design of the box. As you can see the logo of the Wonderbolts. And you see Rainbow Dash in the crest. Just the camera. you can see the Rainbow Dash in the crest. And the style is kind of interesting. With the sort of We Need You style on the show. And of course you see where I got it from, it's called Argos. So they don't show everything out. That's the number. And look at the C at the back. Pinkie Pie's cheering on Sauron. Derpy on the back. She's got her Derpy face. Yeah, the camera's not very good. Well, it is good. Can't zoom in that very well. Yeah, you can't really see her because the camera. Move the camera close, I suppose. That's Pinkie Pie. Derpy. And she does have a wall-eyed look. Kind of. With a picture of a muffin. And her bubble butt. fire is her sort of sleepy face, which is weird because she's usually yelling at people. And they're yelling at ponies, as a cadet would do, a sergeant would do in the army. And Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash flying, probably doing a collision. That's it clearly from an episode of Hurricane Fluttershy. Because she's not really wearing the costume, the uniform. Rainbow Dash is. Pinkie Pie's wearing her cheerleader outfit from the Olympics episode. Yeah, Pinkie Pie's wearing her Olympics episode from the Olympics. And that's pretty much the back. What's that say? The Wonderbolts team has the best slide in the question. Which is weird. And of course, this is warning at the bottom, and of course, I've got a Facebook page. And yeah, the style is sort of like a cadet's 50s or 20s style. It's kind of funny, the box. Our Derpy, or Muffins. Because I didn't really give her a name. As much as I'm going to give her a name, there's a picture of a muffin on it. Because her name is like Dipsy Doo or Dippy Doo. But her fan name is Derpy. Because of reasons. Yeah, it's his reasons. I know this food's not very good, but I can't really think of anything that's working up. So yeah, let's just open this thing up, shall we? Okay, I opened the box, kind of. You know all the characters are there? Put it back a bit. And because I've got all their names on here, you guys saw him with his mohawk. Don't know if I was going. Cheerleader Pinkie Pie. Spitfire, Rainbow Dash, Fluttershy, and Derpy. Let's just see what they do and how easy to take these. Terrible. It's like a really bear. And sure enough, the only accessories you have with them is Pinkie Pie's ribbons. Sauron has a mohawk. Oop, his glasses fell off. Yeah, he has a mohawk. Put his sunglasses on. Put his goggles on. Yep, there's Sauron. Like I said, he has a mohawk. Guess what he actually looks like on the box? Because I gave him a mohawk on toy, but on the box. That's his hairstyle. He doesn't have a mohawk. Kind of, but... Yeah, he doesn't have a mohawk. They made him have one. Because he's completely covered in his... Wonderbolts uniform. Meow! Meow, give me pie! Meow, 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 meow! Oh god, I sound like a shy guy. Yeah, the tail. Normally. His wings, normal. He's got goggles. Bye-bye-bye! I don't know, I can't do that bloody toggle, whatever his name is. Alright, who's next? Let's try and get out Pinkie Pie. Hey. Cheerleader Pinkie Pie. I can't do that. I can't really mimic her. I'm pretty much doing a bin toy bin with her. Yeah, her style. She's got her, typically long hair. She's got her, yeah, she's pretty much got her, Piccamina look at the moment with her hair down like that. I know it's hard for, Hasbro or the companies that make these toys to have fully curly hair like this final doll. It's easier for this because it's made of plastic. But giving her this look, this typically needs a head connect to rotate. Meow. Yeah, she could cheer people ponies on. she comes with bows. Get out the one bells. The head clips. Why do they make it so hard to get these toys out? Yeah, they come with these clips. Let me see with the camera. yeah, come with these clips. Then you put in her hair, her mane, her tail. Alright. There's one. You're very cute so far. And put one in her mane. There we go. Cheerleader Pinkie Pie is on her way. She's ready to cheer some ponies to happiness. Yeah, who's next? Oh yeah, I just noticed. No, I thought they were different sizes. Like Sauron is taller than Pinkie Pie because he's a male. Check her out, and she doesn't have her hairstyle either because of Hasbro. Now I lost the glasses. Help! This review is going terribly. Oops. I can't get the blue glasses. There we go. Now this spot her look. She's got long hair, long mane and tail. Look, this is her hairstyle. I know it's hard for Hasbro, well, the companies who make the toys, to get the style right. Yeah, she's got long hair, long mane. Yeah, she's got long mane. Let's cut her hair out. A bit later. Our glasses keep on falling off. I need something to entertain people while I'm doing this. Yeah, this is her style. Spitfire. Her mane and tail are so long. Oh, but the way it stands like that, it's like she's flying. Like, who's next? Anyway, Rainbow Dash. Anyway, this is your typical model for Rainbow Dash. Your typical model for her. Got the long hair, the typical pony face that you get in every Hasbro toy. Her cutie mark, no cutie mark at the back, they just painted on the Wonderbolt. Painted on the Wonderbolts uniform. I just painted that on. Yeah, just painted that on. And that's about it, just did that, that's how much I changed in the glasses. Yeah, this is pretty much a Rainbow Dash. Let's put her with the rest over here and coop up. Oops, I keep falling off. Alright. Here's all those done so far. And then you got left is Derpy and Fluttershy. I don't know why Fluttershy would choose to team up with Rainbow Dash and Wonderbolt. She prefers to. Even though they're against it, I got Derpy Eyes! Mickey's Derpy Eyes! Iconic Derpy is back! Hasbro's not scared of painting her face normal. Mickey's has a Derpy look! How sweet! And of course, her bubble butt. I don't know why they would let her on Wonderbolt. She can't see very well with her Derpy Eyes. And Fluttershy is scared of everything. Oh, my! Oh, yeah, I got those two. They come with the goggles. Fluttershy with her. She kind of has a Derpy face as well. Her goggles. I don't know why she would join the Wonderbolts. Derpy's not grey. She's sort of bluish. Sort of slate bluish colour. Instead of grey, she's got sort of bluey grey. She's bluey grey on the TV show. And here, she's grey. She's a grey mare with a Derpy face. Because her mane doesn't look like the mane. They all got this typical long mane, so little girls can flash their mane and style them. Anyway, guys, sorry, it's one of my first reviews. Just I'm trying up my camera and showing up perhaps Derpy will wear her goggles. Yeah, actually won't wear them like that. Yeah, this is just a review I've got them yesterday. Now my birthday was Tuesday, my mum sent me a couple of things, those generic ponies, and Derpy's goggles on, fit on her head. There we go. Yeah, her goggles on, fit on her head. Okay guys, these are my pony reviews, and I know that people do that, and of course there's the generic ones. I look like I came straight out of Generation 3. Well, companies who make these generic ponies are out of date. But I have seen Generation 4 style. I think it's still Generation 2. Probably in that sense. Actually, I'll show you. No, they're coming. Generation 2.